मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट. सो इफेक्टिव कैपेसिटेंस विद डायरेक्ट्रिक्स. सो इन सम बुक्स दे विल राइट डायरेक्ट्रिक्स इन सीरीज एंड पैरेलल. सो हेडिंग इज नॉट ए प्रॉब्लम. सो सी देर इज ए टॉपिक आई एक्सप्लेन इन द नोटबुक ऑल्सो. सो सी हियर dielectric slab is introduced. Two dielectric slabs, yeah, three dielectric slabs are introduced between the plates of capacitor. And its first case is area of the plate is divided. So consider already we have one capacitor. So distance between the plates of capacitor is d. So this is called area of cross section. Now I am introducing two dielectric slabs like this. See here, two dielectric slabs having dielectric constant k1 and k2 are introduced, means filled, kept in between the plates of capacitor. So here the total area, so actually total area is capital A. Now the area divided into like this, a by 2 and a by 2, so divided into two parts. Now the question is, what is the effective capacitance? So let us see how I will find the effective capacitance here. So very slowly you have to understand. So first important point is, it is behaving like one capacitor with dielectric. This portion behaves like another capacitor with dielectric. So first one, with K1, so capacitance equal to capacitance C1 equal to. So what is the formula? Capacitance C1 equal to dielectric slab is there, na? Dielectric slab is there. Previously I explained dielectric constant is there. Capacitance is K epsilon naught A by D. Here K1 epsilon naught, area becoming A by 2 by D. So C1 equal to 2 is coming denominator, K1 epsilon naught A by 2 into D. I told you capital A means area of the plate, total area of the plate. Similarly coming to the second capacitor, similarly C2 is equal to, it will be also same, na? So K2 epsilon naught A by 2 whole by D. This is equal to K2 epsilon naught A by 2 into D. Once again I am asking, how you got this formula? Previously I explained in derivation, na? If a dielectric constant K is completely filled, then capacitance is K times KC, K epsilon naught A by D. This is the model I am applying. Now, sir, here two capacitors are there. Now, how to find effective capacitance? See, same diagram I am imagining like this. This one everyone has to understand. See this sentence. Man lijiye, I am connecting a battery here. So I am connecting a battery here. So what will happens? This is the capacitor. This is the capacitor. So half portion is filled with dielectric constant K1 and remaining portion is filled with dielectric constant K2. K1, K2, and I told you I am connecting a battery. Suppose this portion becomes positive, this portion becomes negative. So what will happen here? Imagine, so two capacitors are there. So it is like this is one capacitor, positive, negative. So dielectric constant is like this. Another capacitor K2, positive negative is there, K1 no K2. This is capacitance with K1, capacitance with K2. So already these two are joined indirectly. Dekho, everyone can see what I am doing here. So our original diagram I am changing like this. So same model, na? plus, here portion is plus, here portion is also plus. Here portion is negative, here portion is negative. So that means now you can understand what is the combination of these two capacitors. What is the combination of these two capacitors? Parallel. So hence C1 comma C2 are parallel. Capacitors are parallel. Now apply the same story. So effective capacitance equal to parallel combination means C1 plus C2 formula. Parallel combination C1 plus C2 you can apply. So substitute C1 value. K1 epsilon naught A by 2D plus K2 epsilon naught A by 2D. So C effective equal to K1 plus K2 by 2 is common. So remaining is epsilon naught A by D. Epsilon naught A by D. This epsilon naught A by D. So this is your answer. This epsilon naught A by D. You can write like K1 plus K2 by 2. Epsilon naught A by D is nothing but C. Original capacitance before. This is the original capacitor before dielectric slabs are introduced. So this is the formula. Now you can understand. You can understand here two dielectric slabs are there, K1 and K2. Two dielectric slabs are there, K1 and K2. So they are in parallel like this. This is the formula. K1 plus K2 by 2 into C. So similarly, one more point. Sir, here two dielectric slabs are there here. In the question, two dielectric slabs are there, K1, K2. That is why I am getting by 2. Suppose if three dielectrics are there, if three dielectrics are there, like this is the capacitor plates, three dielectrics are there. So here portion is K1, here portion is filled with K2, here portion is filled with K3. Then what is the effective capacitance? C effective is equal to, similar model you can follow, K1 plus K2 plus K3 by 3 of epsilon naught A by D. Okay, or C effective equal to K1 plus K2 plus K3 by 3 epsilon naught A by D means C. So this is the model. So remember, now this is the first model. Capacitors are connected, so one over the other, so parallel combination. So this is case 1. Coming to the case 2 like this. Okay. Coming to the second case, distance divided. Distance between the plates is divided. Sir, how? See this diagram. Once again, mere paas is a capacitor is there like this. So distance between the plates is D. Distance between the plates is D like this. So area of the plate is A. Total area of the plate is dA. Now the question is, distance between the plates is divided with dielectrics. So how? So here I am keeping one dielectric slab. So dielectric slab having a dielectric constant completely. So this is one dielectric slab. So dielectric slab is, I am keeping here. So dielectric constant is, this is like K1. It is K1 like this. So beside another dielectric also I am keeping here. Another dielectric also I am keeping here. So this is another dielectric here. So another dielectric slab side by side like series. Another dielectric slab. Dielectric constant is K2 I kept here. So both are I kept here side by side like this. Side by side. Now the question is, what is the effective capacitance? So how to find effective capacitance here? First, I told you already, so area of capacitor plate is same, but a distance is divided here. So this portion is D by 2, this portion is D by 2. So distance between the plates is divided exactly half. See, same diagram, I am modifying, equivalent diagram I am modifying. Imagine this portion is connected to a battery, this portion becomes positive, this portion becomes positive like this. Positive and positive like this. Now this is the original plates, actually original plates, but half portion with dielectric, half portion with dielectric, I told you already, half portion with dielectric, d by 2. Now this total portion, entire portion becomes positive like this, okay, positive. So this side also you will get negative and positive. This side you will get negative and positive. Previously I explained electric polarization concept. So there I explained this concept. Here battery negative is there. Automatically this side you will get positive, this side you will get negative like this. Okay, na? So plus minus alternatively you are getting like this. Now this is K2 and this is K1. And if you see plus minus, two plates, two capacitor plates are plus minus, it seems to be like, if you remember, I explained in the previous question like this, plus minus, so two capacitors are there, so a battery is connected like this, positive and negative like this, do you remember? Now you will understand. So this is with dielectric constant K, this is with dielectric constant K1, this is with dielectric constant K2, so two capacitors are there. So what is the combination here? Side by side. So you will understand capacitors are in series. So now I am saying simple word. Dielectric constant K1 is introduced in this region. So this portion behaves like first capacitor. Electric constant K2 is kept here. This portion behaves like second capacitor. So what is the capacitance of first capacitor? What is the capacitance of second capacitor? Let me explain using the basic formula once again. Capacitance C equal to, generally I told you already in the previous class, capacitance equal to, this is the formula, na, K epsilon naught A by D model. A means area, D means distance here. Same formula, this is our formula I am using here. Using this formula, capacitance with dielectric constant K1. Capacitance with dielectric constant K1. What is the formula? C1 is equal to, this is K1, epsilon naught A by, distance means D by 2. So this fraction will reverse. So 2K1, epsilon naught A by D. So this is the formula. So capacitance with dielectric constant K1 is, this is the formula. So similarly, C2 means dielectric constant K2 is kept here. C2 equal to, same model, K2 epsilon naught A by, distance means D by 2. So reverse, 2K2 epsilon naught A by D. This is the formula. So C1, C2 are two capacitances here. I told you, as per my equivalent circuit, capacitors are side by side here. Equivalent circuit, capacitors are side by side. So here you will understand C1, C2 are in series. C1, C2 are in series. So C effective equal to formula C1, C2 by C1 plus C2 formula. So C1 means 2K1 epsilon naught A by D. C2 means 2K2 epsilon naught A by D whole by, again 2K1 epsilon naught A by D plus 2K2 epsilon naught A by D like this. So this is C effective equal to, so here and here you can take the common term, epsilon naught A by D, epsilon naught A by D is common. So here 2K1, 2K2 is there, 2K1, 2K2, epsilon naught A by D, two terms are here, epsilon naught A by D, two terms are here, whole by, here you can take epsilon naught A by D as common, so remaining terms are here 2K1 plus 2K2, 2K1 plus 2K2 like this. So now check it, here you will understand this is 2 into 2, 4, K1, K2, whole by 2 of K1 plus K2. So one term will cancel, you will get epsilon naught A by D. So 2 2's cancel, that implies C effective equal to 2K1 K2 by K1 plus K2. So which is into epsilon naught A by D. So this is your capacitance formula. Like I told you, it seems to be like dielectric slabs are in series. Dielectric slabs are in series. Side by side, na dielectric slabs are in series. So finally, this is the formula you will get here. I told you, this epsilon naught A by D is nothing but original capacitance with the air or vacuum. This is the formula. So remember this sentence. Now once again, here I explain two cases. So first case is the electric slabs are kept one over the other, just like parallel. This is the second case. So in first case, area divided into two equal parts. So finally, you will get this is the formula. Once again, I am repeating. And second case, you can see the second case, distance divided here. Equally, I am dividing d by 2, d by 2. Then effective capacitance will be like this. This bracket term I am saying, it is like effective dielectric constant. 2k1 k2 by k1 plus k2. Here k1 plus k2 by 2, it is the effective dielectric constant. Okay, now if you see, sir, at a time, so this is the note point, another application, you can see this is a parallel plate capacitor. So this portion is filled with the dielectric constant K1. This portion is filled with the dielectric constant K2. And this total portion is filled with the dielectric constant K3. K1, K2 and K3. Okay, na? So then again you can apply. So how to find this dielectric constant value? Everyone can see. So apply. What is the combination of these two here? Tell me. K1, K2 combination, tell me. K1, K2 are in parallel combination. Okay, na? And what about the combination behaves like? Series with K3. Try to understand. So, shortcut I am writing like this. So, it is one capacitor. This is another capacitor like this. This is like K3 epsilon naught A by D. This is one. Okay, na? Epsilon naught A by. So here I am saying once again distance divided like this. So this is the second capacitor K3. Okay, na? What about this one? First one, I told you these two are in parallel combination. You will get K1 plus K2 by 2. This is epsilon naught A by D. So here first capacitor is there like this. Second capacitor is there. Again, what is the combination of these two? So again, combination of these two is nothing but series. So same model formula, same model C1, C2 by C1 plus C2 model. You can apply. You can apply here also. This is C1. It is behaving like C2. So both you can apply. You will get the answer. Okay. Okay, students, coming to the next concept, force between the plates of capacitor. This is also another important concept. You can see